Hello, welcome to Bean Talk. I'm your host, Carl Bean. I was watching Star Wars The Empire Strikes Back last night when it occurred to me that you could easily call it Star Wars Everybody Has a Bad Day if you just reframed it a little. Consider this. A wampa got its arm cut off by the man it found while hunting for something it could eat for lunch. Luke Skywalker was attacked by a wampa and then proceeded to crash twice in the first day. First, he crashed his snowspeeder into the snow, and then he crashed his X-Wing fighter into a swamp. It's a miracle nobody took extra precautions when he landed on Cloud City. Can we stop right here and talk about what his X-Wing fighter must have smelled like after being pulled out of a swamp? Poor Luke must have held his nose the entire way, not to mention his seat, which was probably all soggy. And I bet when he lowered the landing gear as he was landing on Bespin, a snake and a couple of turtles probably fell out. Moving on, Han Solo was trapped on board the Millennium Falcon with bossy Princess Leia while they were avoiding capture by Star Destroyers, flew through an asteroid field, nearly got his ship digested by a space worm, and got his favorite blaster yoinked away by Darth Vader. If I were him, I would have welcomed the relaxing nothingness of being frozen in carbonite after that kind of day. And now let's talk about C-3PO. C-3PO was blown up by stormtroopers, then slowly reassembled throughout the last act of the movie. But wait a minute. Let's talk about C-3PO's body being blown apart into several mostly intact pieces when he's hit by a laser bolt at close range. How is this possible? And how did Chewbacca manage to grab all the right pieces while he was saving C-3PO from the Ugnaughts in the smelting plant? Seems more likely that he would have grabbed the wrong part or missed something. Imagine if, at the end of the movie, they zoomed away from the main characters and C-3PO tried to pick up a pitcher of coffee, but he can't because he's missing a thumb. Now that would be a twist ending. Darth Vader is the toughest Imperial bad guy in the movie, but that doesn't mean that he's immune to having a bad day. This movie proves it. At the beginning of the movie, Vader reaches a hangar inside the Rebel base just as the Millennium Falcon manages to blast off. Later, the Millennium Falcon manages to elude the entire fleet of Star Destroyers. He finally catches Leia, Han Solo, and Chewbacca, only to have them escape again, and his attempts to recruit Luke don't go exactly as planned. Whatever happened to the other bounty hunters that Darth Vader hired to catch Han Solo? They gathered on the bridge of the Executor, but we never saw them again. They definitely didn't get their bounty because Boba Fett did. So I'm willing to bet that they all had a bad day. Come to think of it, Boba Fett was the only character in the movie who was having a good day. I mean, he figured out where the Millennium Falcon was hiding, was able to lead the Empire to Cloud City before Han Solo and company arrived, was paid by the Empire for his help, and was going to be paid a second reward by Jabba the Hutt when he delivered the Han Solo on Tatooine. I can only imagine the grin on Boba Fett's face as he flew away from Bespin in his ship. What other characters would you say were having either a good day or a bad day while the events of the movie were taking place? Comment below.